So here we will discuss with both of them, that is amendment as well as about the fine sulfur and how to go with the fine sulfur and what was the Reynolds number and all this. So the amendment for the MSBC in 1st January 2017 it was, and it is circular number should also be written over here, that is 1395. So 1st January 2017 MSBC over here, and here MSC circular number 1395, revision 1, revision 2 is all been replaced and what has been done. So we will go through just these things. So what happened after all these? So it is like convention is MSBC resolution by which it has been passed, then ship type which are involved, sizes, compliance state, ship type, sizes, and again compliance state and subject, then remarks. So amendment to the MSBC code is the new set of the amendment and all this. So here important is a new section 14, that is prevention of the pollution by the cargo residue from the ship is included in the amendment. And this one, then here an addition has been made in the section 3. So section 3 also have a new amendment, and the amendment including a new schedule for the iron ore fines, that is been iron ore fines been included in group A, and new test procedure for determining TML. So they have now new determination, means the procedure for determining the TML, they have new procedures. So these things are new one. So here is iron is new, section 3 has been added, then section in section 3 something new is added, section 14 itself fully added, because previously it was till 13 only and annex was till 4 only. So one more annex, annex 5 is also added, we'll show you that also. So new cargo has been included in some of the existing cargo deleted from the code. So cargo wood pellets not deleted, and instead of that following cargo added, wood pellets containing and or binders additives. So this is included, wood pellets not containing binders are also and additives. So these are all added, and revision 1 is being replaced by revision 2, list of the solid bulk cargoes for which the fixed gas fire extinguishing system may be exempted or for which the fire gas and fire extinguishing system is ineffective. Okay, so ineffective, so this one is list of the solid bulk cargoes for which the fixed gas fire extinguishing system may be exempted or for which the fixed fire gas extinguishing is ineffective. So this is what is the, so here you can see this, the document MSC circular number 1395 revision 2. So this one is the circular, and here table list of the solid bulk for which the fixed gas fire extinguishing system may be exempted. So it is ore, coal, grain, uncensored timber. And then cargo listed in the international, that is MSBC code, which are not combustible or constitute a low fire as follows. All the cargoes not categorized into category B of MSBC code, and the following cargoes categorized into B in the MSBC code are these. So these all cargoes, then run these. So actually I am showing first the amendment, and then after we will go to the fine sulfur also. So metal sulfide concentration, so because here is the sulfur, that's why I remember this one. So they are assessed in accordance with the 1.3 of the code. They do not present hazards of the group B as. So these things you can just go through these notices. Here is nothing much, that list of the cargo which is exempted, which are not exempted, that is given. So list of the solid bulk cargo for which a fire a fixed gas fire extinguishing system is ineffective and for which a fixed extinguishing system given equivalent protection shall be available. So what all these cargoes are: aluminium nitrate, ammonium nitrate, UN numbers are, this means that they are DGs with not more than 0.2 total combustible material, including any organic substances calculated as carbon or the exclusion of any additives. So all these, because you can see all of them are having UN numbers, so they are all of them are general DGs. So these are the, this is MSC circular number 1395. So this one was included in amendments. So this one, as well as now few cargoes. So what are the few cargoes? Following new cargoes has been added. Which are the cargo? This is amorphous sodium silicate lumps, first one. Second one, boric acid. Third one is clinker ash. The spelling is CLINKERASH, that is Charlie Lima India November Kilo Echo Romeo and Space, then Alpha Sierra Hotel. So this cargo, and the last one is wooden pellet not containing any additives and binders. So these all are added as a new cargo. So I will make them big one so that, okay, so that you can just, okay, now, so here you can see this is the new amendment. So first one is iron ore. Actually, first one I was taking as a new section. So new section, that is section number 14, has been added, and NX5 is added, and NX5 is added. So I will show you this NX5. Here you can see section 14, prevention of the pollution by the cargo residue from the ship. Prevention number 14, you can see. Prevention of the pollution by the cargo residue from the ship. And the last one is Appendix 5, bulk cargo shipping names in 3 languages. So these were, this is actually the content page of the MSBC code. So this is the same thing is written over there, nothing different. So section 14 is there and section 5 is there. So these thing I won't. So these two things, 14 and 5, is included, and then we have addition in section 3. The section 3 now requires the ship crew to conduct regular onboard operational fire safety assessment of the cargo handling areas or the self unloading bulk carriers installed with internal conveyor system and all this. And then iron ore, new procedures to determine TML. And for the fire extinguishing system. So this is MSC circular number 1395. So this is there. And some 4 new cargoes. That is amorphous sodium silicate lumps, boric acid, clinker ash, wooden pellets. So this one is for amendments. And now we will go to sulfur. So sulfur now. So it is notice number 22-1998 after the Arcadia Pride. So in the recent sinkage of the MS Arcadia Pride, resulting in the loss of the lives and the damage of the property. So actually it came after the Arcadia Pride, which sank. So damage to the property was investigated and all this. So the cargo of the sulfur carried on board the ship from the port of Ruwais was determined to be a fine granule sulfur in the form of pellets 2 to 3 mm diameter. The behavior of this cargo was examined by way of a model made to a scale. It was observed that the granule sulfur behaved like a grain cargo, unlike sulfur powder. So it was behaving like a grain rather than sulfur powder. So the stowage factor of the cargo carried on board the Arcadia Prize were determined to be 0.787 meter cube per ton, and angle of repose were determined as 25 degrees. This is 25 degrees. It was almost determined that the cargo, if left untrimmed, that would result in 30 to 50% void spaces in our cargo hold, and the rolling and the pitching of the ship will untrim. Cargo would initially tend to settle the cargo and subsequently shift as like a grain. So then what happened? So in the view of the above, the nautical advisory of the Government of India has prohibited the loading of the granule sulfur cargo in the bulk on board general cargo ship calling an Indian ports. The Indian ports authorities are advised to inform that the concerned principal officer of the MMD and all this. So it means that, okay, so it is only this thing. What was important is that in India it is as per MS notice number this one, but different countries will have different notices number, so you can check your notice number. And Arcadia Pride, the vessel was actually Arcadia Pride, and where it was not loaded as per the, because the sulfur, granule sulfur behaves like a grain, so the caution was not taken. That's why this incident didn't happen. And thereafter the granule sulfur was put up or should be loaded as per the grain code only. So it should be loaded, lashed, and everything should be done as per the, like, for the grain only. So these were the this is the important part. So what we have here to say is Arcadia Pride was lost because of the granule sulfur, which was not loaded as per the grain code, and it should be now loaded in as per the grain code as per the country's notice numbers. And if you want more one, so angle of repose is there, and angle of repose is given, and stowage factor, all of them is given, so you can go through all these things. So these will also helpful. And in India it is MS notice number 22 of 1998. So this is all about the all about the sulfur. So you can read this one. I haven't read this one much, but because this is not of much importance, if you want you can read this. I will wait for 2 minutes, 1 or 2 minutes, so that you can have it. One more thing, this clinker ash, what has been mentioned is it is non-combustible residue actually. So clinker ashes means that it is non-combustible ashes. Okay, thank you.